What's going on, guys? Welcome to another back testing video. We're literally just picking up where we left off in yesterday's video, looking at GBP USD. We're just about to hit the New York session on Monday, and yeah, I'm just looking at the I believe these are accumulations because we're doing runs on stops, so I'm assuming that's what accumulation is. But the reason I'm focusing heavily on it is because I'm not very strong with accumulation. But yeah, once we trade back into this breakaway gap, which is a fair value gap, we fill it, price trace to the top of it, and then eventually we break lower and we trade away. We have a nice breaker here, so we can mark this range out. Beautiful breaker, absolutely beautiful. Why is it beautiful? Look at the delivery of price through it. I sound like such a nerd. But yep, we have a breakaway gap here. No, sorry, what am I saying? Breaker with a breakaway gap inside. Is there a breakaway? Well, no, the breakaway gap's up here, which gets formed in the breakaway gap. Funny. Then we have a nice entry on this fair value gap here. This is a beautiful 2020 model. Just touches into it, doesn't trade into it completely, but it does touch it. And we're also respecting the 50% level absolutely gorgeously as well. So we can put a sell. Beautiful entry on that candle as we trade into the breaker. We've set the 50% level, and then what happens? We continue to trade away, running out lows. Look at what happens every time we take out a low. We have a one stops. Take out this low. And then we take out this low as well. Look how we trade back into this range here, which is kind of like a mitigation block in its own way. Then we break lower, run into this low, pull back, have a run on stops, and then we continue to the downside, and it starts to get very ziggy zaggy price action again as we come to the end, and it goes into consolidation. But let's just look at it. And I'm gonna do the same thing I did in the last video. I'm gonna take a look at how each time it takes out a low, pull back into the range, takes out another swing low here, pulls back into the range a couple times. Takes out another swing low here, takes out this swing low here. It's just constantly pulling back into the range. Interesting to see how we trade into this high value gap. Then eventually you take out this low and this low. And then it pretty much goes to consolidation after that. So I'm going to go straight up to the Tuesday. Don't forget to watch yesterday's video to see everything we've done in this And yeah, let me just get all the lines and everything sorted for the next day. So here we are. It's gonna mark out the high of the age range as per usual, the low point. The high, the low, and then the midpoint of the Asia. See, we come up and then we break in market structure here. Price then off, we then again entry. We do have a breaking market structure here as well. If we wanted a very tight entry. So we'll take that into consideration. Fair value gap here. We enter there and then run another fair value gap here that we enter here, and then we've taken out biceps here, and then here. And then where we'll be aiming for, probably this window on these relative equal lows resting below there. So we can mark that out as sell side liquidity, and then we can put a sell here and a sell here. Because these are both entries. So once we trade lower, this is technically a breaker, high, low, high, high, break, lower. So this is also a breaker in its own right, meaning that we can be selling all through here comfortably. And then we get out of our position just below here. Then you can see we're going to like a very thick consolidation. So what we do, we're accumulation. This is all accumulation. Displacement to the downside, pull back up to the mitigation block, so to speak. And we continue. Let's look at that price action actually. This is interesting. So we have these fair value gaps that are constantly getting filled. That's just been filled there. This one gets filled here. This one should anticipate getting filled, but it goes past that, doesn't it? Yeah. So I guess you can look at this as like a little breakaway gap just before we trade down past the 50% level of the range, but we wouldn't know it's 50% of the range at that time. But we do have a breakout structure here. Fair value gap here. I guess this is a breaker here, high, low, high, high. So we could look at this little range here as a breaker. But we don't even trade to it, so maybe we shouldn't. Anyway, we trade up.
Respect the 50% level off that fair value gap, which is bearish. This one completely fills the range. And then we eventually have a reversal, low, high, low, low, then break higher. Creating us a nice big breaker range here. And we'll look at how price treats this breaker as we enter the London session. So we have accumulation here, manipulation as we run back up, taking out this swing high right before the break lower. So we can anticipate that getting taken, that being the high we aim for. And then yeah, let's look at how it goes up to these levels. So where's our breaking structure? Here. Then we have a rebalance here. But it trades back up into this. Then this is a breaker, high, low, high, high, break, lower. But we don't actually trade into this, we trade up to this candle, though, this wick. And then this here is I like to call it an inversion order block. So we can enter on this candle here. Excuse me. Then we touch that old high, buy, come lower. Touch that old high, buy, come lower. It seems like we're constantly touching the under and under off this high on the way low, on the way down, which is interesting. And then we get back to that breaker where we pull right back up into this range here. Relative equal holes, lows, relative equal holes. And then we have the London session aggressively trading lower, taking out the sell side. And also another thing to note, we took out 50% of that Asia range before breaking lower and kissing it goodbye. Yeah, as soon as this London session starts, we move lower, and we have a nice little entry just above this swing high here, so into this fair value gap. And then we'd be aiming for, well, I don't know where we're aiming for specifically, if I can't see. The this low here acts as a breaker, and we do trade to it here. But you can see the whole session is very consolidated, but we should then move lower, and we do. But why is this a breaker? Because we have a high, a low, a higher high, and we break lower. So this is a low. This low does act as a breaker low. That means we can actually cast this range from this high. Lower. To minus one, and use that as a measured target. That's where I'd want to get out of my position. As soon as we trade it below that. And then we kind of go into this crazy choppiness. And I'm going to do the same thing I've been doing. Look at how each low gets ran. This is my inversion order block. And also just to run on stops that we can anticipate. Order block here. Order block here, order block here. Until we eventually reach target and we break down and we run back down into a breaker. Low, high, lower, low. We don't even touch it, so. How relevant is it? I don't like this chop, to be honest. Like, at what point do you want to be buying, you know? I guess after this run and we take out this buy side like that, that would signify a run. Because you'd recognize that we'll fail to take out this low, took out this low. We fail to take out this low. We're taking out this swing high. With a fair value gap, we should act as a breakaway gap so it doesn't get traded to. And then we push into this high, so yeah, this would be a buy. Let's look at Thursday first, it looks fun. I mean, we can look at this. We should be looking at how we step down out of this range. So we are just going to skip to Thursday, starting with Wednesday's Asian session. Very precise price action here. Look at this breakout, low, high, lower, low, break higher. So this range makes a really nice breaker. Not the best price action in the world, but it's what it is. And then we'd want to get out as soon as this buy side gets tagged, so on this candle here. We have a nice run of stops, breaking market structure, run below these lows. Eventually taking out these lows, and then we have the Asian session low here. Both sides of the Asian session get taken out, and I'll show you that here. Buy side gets taken out there, sell side gets taken out there. So we have the manipulation phase after the London session here, where we start to run lower aggressively too. Into this mitigation block. break it here. See how we touch it. Low, high, low, low. Break higher. As soon as this swing high takes out this, it's pretty much ready to go, but we can look at this swing high as well. Find support on that. Nice little entry there. Very small entry here, is there? No, they respect that one. And we just keep running up and find support. Pull back. Pull back. Back and then relative equal highs, pull back, support, expansion, and then yeah, continuation. But we do have a breaker. This is a break, low, high, lower, low, and then we break higher. So this range, it is a breaker, which means we can be buying all the way through that breaker, which is interesting. We should draw that out. Now a big one on stops like this would be 50% of the range. Probably a little bit more, but let's mark out 5 a.m. and I am going to bring this video to an end very shortly. Beautiful relative equal highs above here. Then we have a nice breaker, low, high, low, low, or even this candle. Probably this range in general. And yeah, that's going to bring us to the end, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.